Hello everyone and welcome back to Evoland 2. In the last episode we came up here to the ruins of Dominia, or what is soon to be the ruins of Dominia in the past, and are working our way to try and save Dominia from the Great Magus, who was rebelling from the Empire? I don't know, but I think there's a different word for that. He's defecting. I guess that's it. Anyway, we teamed up with the Colonel, and now we're going through these outposts in a military or turn-based strategy kind of combat style. Perfect. This camp probably belongs to the patrol we bumped into. Let's set up here for now. Listen here, Exterminator. To wage war, you need troops. I can bring over some from the Empire. The more victories we secure, the more soldiers will be inclined to join up with us. Go see if you can muster troops from the command tent. Then join me to secure the area. Okay, so we will be building an army. It was kind of mentioned when he joined us that that could happen. Is this the command tent? Welcome to the command tent. So we have these war credits we can use to buy and upgrade soldiers. So this is kind of cool. It kind of reminds me of like Age of Empires, even though that was real-time and not turn-based, I think. I don't know, the versions I played were real-time, I think. I know there's lots of games like that though, but that's the one I played. So we have one recruit and we can now upgrade him. So when we fight in the war, we get those little war credits. So yeah, apparently this did belong to that patrol, so we got this secure. Excellent, now we have more than an advantage. Let's move forward. Okay, so I actually like this game mode, or I think I like it a lot more than the previous ones. Like the brawl one I wasn't good at, the lab one with the whole turn-based combat wasn't my style either, but I don't know, this one's a bit more tactical, I guess, and I know I've played games like this before, I just cannot remember the name of the games, so it seems our problems have caught up with us. Oh boy. Lord Magus, the Imperial troops have landed on our shores.
Already? Impossible.
They're attacking, all right.
Must be that ritual Colonel Dalek
something else.
If he thinks he can foil my plans with a few greenhorns, he is surely mistaken.
Indeed, my lord. He's a fool.
Only the Colonel himself poses a risk. Once you have disposed of him, his army will collapse like a house of cards.
Me?
Of course you. Who else would I be telling all... Why else would I be telling you all this?
I thought you merely liked being listened to, my lord.
This is a matter of military tactics, and it is that, and that is your specialty, is it not? Ergo, you shall lead this operation.
Ah, I see. But can I refuse?
Two arms!
Things are really heating up for us. Best not to go off half-cocked. Let's review everyone's particular skill set.
I can heal everyone who's wounded.
I am able to repel many foes in a single blow.
I have the freeze power that prevents enemies from countering.
I will provide cover if you stay close to me.
And Kuru?
As per usual, he will hack and slash.
You have to admit that served him pretty well.
Excellent! Forward march!
Okay, that was also a nice summary of all our abilities, because I do not know half of them that well. I actually want to see where everyone can move, and this guy, so... Okay, I think I would like to focus up more than down. Or, I don't know, there's a lot of things. The Magus isn't here, but we have a lot of those guys to deal with. And are these archers? Recruits. So I did say before how I would, these are the archers. So I would like to get away from the archers, and I think these trees could provide cover. You know, being all tactical here. I think... Okay, so she can't attack from there. I don't know, I would like to get it where she can attack. Okay, so she can attack from here, so I think I'll use that, because she has the only ranged attack. Which, once again, really think that's... Or, I really don't like that, but... Yeah, I guess Velvet will have to go here, and I want her to charge. Because I think that will charge her ice attack. I haven't tried her attack yet, but I know in the other game... modes, it was a lot better at defeating an army of people sort of thing, or like it would hit an area. I don't think I can get this guy here. Maybe if I move Manos. I'll try moving Manos behind me. What's the difference between wait and charge? I want to charge and just see what he does. So can I get the... No, he can't get there. So I guess the next best thing is get this guy here. Wait and him here. And can I say protect? And that whole area should be protected. So if they attack any of us... Okay, but none of these guys should be able to reach us. Maybe the archers at best can shoot one of us, but hopefully the protect will keep us protected. You know, as its name suggests. Okay. Punch. Okay. I want to see if she can freeze all of these. Okay, so she does a pretty large area. Oops, I did not mean to do it. I want to move her back and freeze and try and get this guy too. But actually, if I went like here, I bet I could have froze more of them. Either way, it got most of them. So I'm not complaining there. There we go. Okay, I wanted to see if I could shoot through my own team, and I can. So I guess that leaves crew can go up here. And I guess just take out that recruit. My recruit is gonna go up here and attack the other recruit. Oh god, he's really strong. I probably should have thought that through better and weakened him with one of my stronger fighters first. Let's see. I think Menos will go here and... Oh, he only has punch charged up. Well. That, did it. And I think he's gonna go here and just protect. So he will protect anyone who gets attacked there, which is really cool. That also can damage him a lot. But at least no one's attacking me. Okay, I take that back. Oh, and I killed him in retaliation. Retaliation is something else I have to keep in mind for this. Darn. So when he protects, he doesn't retaliate, but every other time he will. Okay, that's kind of risky. Not sure if I should fall back or not. I can't really get behind the trees, so hiding from the archers isn't gonna work too well. Actually, I think I'm gonna have Manos fall back and charge, and Velvet fall back and charge, and try and wait more for them to come to us. Let's see. From here, Fina should be able to attack this guy. And then I can go here and attack this guy. And then our recruit here can go here and attack this guy. And we defeated them. And that leaves him, who's going to stay here and protect. And hopefully that will keep us all safe. Okay. Being tactical about this, because hopefully the colonel isn't taking too much damage either. Yeah, I think he still has well over half health. I'll try and heal him next turn. Yeah, he really needs a heal. Okay, so if I go here with Manos and punch, he's going to hit everyone. Fina will head back here. Actually, first I want to see where Velvet can go, because I actually didn't think about that very well. So her ice will, Okay, if she moves here, her ice should hit everyone, right? Yes. There we go. This recruit, So I actually think Fina's gonna stay here and heal him. Oh, that healed a lot. I guess it might be relative. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. So he can still move, and I can still move, And how much health do these guys have? So he's dead, no matter who attacks him. He might not be. So I'm going to send him here on attack instead of protect, since they don't really have as much. I should be able to... Yes, I should be able to get down here and actually attack the commander. He can't actually get there. Maybe if I move, he'll have a better path. So... Nope, he still can't get down there. So I guess I'll move him there and wait and... Uh-oh. Ow. So I think I need everyone to now attack this guy. And oh my god, that guy's just getting slightly out of my range. I guess Fiend will have to go and take care of him. He just had 4 hit points, so he's just holding on. Which is really annoying. So, okay. He can't get there, but he can protect, so I'm gonna send him here and protect just in case the other guy lives. Manos can get to the back and attack for a good bit of damage. Oh god, he hit hard. I think I'm going to attack with myself. Let's just head to this side. Attack. Don't hit me back too hard. Okay, only 19. I have better armor than Manos, so I forgot about that. And, okay, so I can, Velvet doesn't kill, the other guy will. Or not. Whoops. Huh. Ooh. Whoops. There we go. Things are starting to look up. After that victory, we should be able to build a fortified encampment that will accommodate our staff. We're not going to stay in this dirty old camp much longer, are we? I could use a little more breathing room. Not to worry, Miss Fina. We shall be moving to take command of advancing troops. I've been studying the geography of this Isle of Dominia. Several paths lead to the capital. The southern route is the fastest, but that's where the bulk of the rebels' mobile forces are. The north is longer, but easier to traverse. There's a path to the enemy... That's the path the enemies use to transport their siege weapons. It behooves us to choose carefully. Let Kuro decide. He always knows what to do next. Alright, we'll see. We'll see when we get there. Let's head out. Apparently, I'm near death. So, can I buy any more troops? Because I think my one troop died. I still do have one. Oh, I can upgrade him to soldier or archer. That's really useful. I think I'm going to upgrade him to an archer. Because archers are cool. And buy another recruit. And I wish I had a heal, but I do not know how to heal at this point. Because, let's see. It doesn't really show my health anywhere. So I guess I just walk out here now and on to the next place. Okay. So yeah, there's the north or south, I guess. And when I was walking around, it just looked like dead area. But pretty much both are going to be tough in different ways. Okay, the health sound's gone. There's a lot of equipment lying around here. Evidently, they retreated in a hurry. Doesn't surprise me. They figured out who's the boss. But to simply leave without taking up arms. I imagine their commanding officer fled. Once that happens, there's no way to keep the troops from abandoning their post. That's great. If our presence is enough to scare off the Emperor's senior officers, we just need to plow through. I see a command tent over there. Let's use it to recruit more soldiers. Well, I kind of already did that. I actually thought we'd be recruiting a lot more soldiers. Yeah, I can't buy any more. A lot more soldiers, and another army. Now, charge! Oh. I think we know why they left so quickly. This is what scared them off. Should we take off too? I believe that's out of the question for now. Let me speak with them. They are demons, so they're not likely to harm us if I can explain the situation. Down with the invaders! Calm yourselves. Pray, lay down your weapons. Tis I, Menno, son of our king. I have come to liberate Dominia.
Menos? The one who betrayed his own father, bringing humans? The one who allied himself with the colonel of the Empire? Death to the traitors!
It won't be easy to persuade them, Menos.
But I do not wish to fight them. We have no choice. It is either them or us.
Forgive me, dear compatriots, but I have a mission to fulfill.
Okay, so now we have to fight the demons, which might be stronger. Okay, so the archers are the blue ones, I take it. Not all of them, just the one with the bow. That one's an archer. Actually, it does look like all the blue-haired ones are archers. Huh. So, I think I'd rather focus. Which way do I want to focus here? Okay, so let's see. He can get up here. So let's start with him. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do is try and take out as many as I can as quickly as I can. So I'm going to use him to take out this one. I thought that would happen. So now if I take him, go here, attack. He can take out this. He should be able to finish off him. And, I don't know, I said before I might cut out battles, but I think that will mostly apply to battles where, can Kuru walk up there? Yes. Let's see, go here. 30. Let's compare attack strengths as well to see if that will work. 38. Yeah, she's strong enough that I think we can take out the demon. Almost, but Fina should be able to finish that up. I was going to use her to heal if I could, but... Well, this seems a little more useful, because less damage dealt to me is as good as a heal, kind of, especially when I'm kind of high on health still. So, I think only the archers will be able to hit me now. Just those two, I think, mainly. Which isn't the most ideal, but like all those ones down there have to catch up now, which is good. Oh, actually, only one archer is able to hit us, so that went well. Yeah, all these guys down here are definitely going to be a problem. So I think I'm going to put Menos like right in the center here and charge him. And he'll probably take out the stuff down there. So, let's see. Okay, he can get up here. So he's going to attack him. Oh, I meant to actually say protect. Or like have him protect, but I forgot he couldn't do that once he attacks. I'm actually going to put her down here and charge. Let's see. The archer's going to go here and attack him. But yeah, like I was saying, I would like to cut up more of this, but since this is my first battle of demons, I thought it was worth putting in the episode. So, I don't know. In the future, I might cut out a bit more, but for now, I think I'm going to leave it as is. Let's see. She'll head here, and does anyone need a heal? They're actually both pretty good. So, I think I'll put her up here and attack the demon just to reduce herself a bit. And then this guy will just head here, because he can't reach anyone anyway to want to try and not spread my forces out too much. Darn. Okay, so all these guys coming in, I think Menos is just gonna wreck them all. Oh my god, he one-shot the archer. That is not good. Okay, so first I'm gonna start with Menos down here, because he charged up a punch. Okay, so now we have, I think Menos really needs to protect, though, so I'm actually just going to come down here and say protect. I think that would also work for her ice. Okay, so they're all covered in the protect. How weak is this guy? Let's hope that's enough. How weak is this guy?
So that one's actually weaker. So I actually think up here would be the best spot, because, you know, I don't want these guys to die, but they also kind of need to attack. So he's probably going to get killed now. Great. Menos really does need a heal, though. So this guy's really weak. I actually think what I'm going to do is send Fina here. Heal Menos just to be safe, because he's definitely one of our heavy hitters. And take care of this guy, leaving just that one archer up there. And hopefully this goes well. So he's going to block hits on everyone there. Yep. So pretty much just that one guy's going to die. Darn recruits. At least they don't actually die and I lose them. Okay, Menos is going to head here. Take out the archer. I'm just going to send Velvet out here. I don't think she can one-shot him. But I don't think he can one-shot her either. Because she has pretty decent armor. Let's see. Yeah, I am running low on troops for this. Actually, I think Fina, even from here, should be able to take him out. If that hit like a 10, I'd be pretty annoyed. His attack's better than mine. So I'm actually going to send him up here to take out this guy. And I'm going to try and take out this one. And if they both live, I'll be a bit annoyed. Well, should probably switch that around. Okay, but it looks like we will win this easily enough. I should kill him in retaliation, and yeah. Whew. So he should definitely be able to take out him. And I'd be surprised if Velvet can't defeat him when he only has 11. Because I think she hit way more than that. Whew. Only a 14. That could have actually been bad. War is truly a woeful thing. Here we are, forced to class of those we sought to protect. I'm deeply sorry, Menos. I feel like I got their voices mixed up. I'm deeply sorry, Menos. And I know how you feel. Don't give up hope, Menos. We're gonna stop Magus and save your people. At any rate, we now face two enemies. We'll have to exercise even more caution. I hope we can save more of my kind than we will have. We'll have to be killed. All this is futile otherwise. Well, we are in the past, so doesn't look too good. Okay, so now's the choice where we go north or south. So up here we have to deal with siege weapons. And it looks like it really kind of loops back around anyway, or at least at that point. Does it go off more north? Doesn't really look like it. So pretty much just two fights up here or two fights down there. I'm actually going to pick siege weapons, because I think I'd rather deal with that. I wonder if the Magus would have been in whichever one he picked. Lieutenants, we shall be laying siege to Dominia. Those catapults must be kept in absolute perfect condition. I'm counting on you to protect them on our journey. My lord, you are a great wizard. Thank you. That is, you must have plenty of magical powers, mystical relics, and that sort of thing, right? Yes, yes, of course. What are you getting at? Well, why have us move these great powerful machines on our own? You can make them fly, teleport them, or even use a magical ward, couldn't you? Look at the time. I really must be going. Good luck. Oh, and it's even the slight scratch on those catapults is coming out of your pay. Soldiers, forward march. Huh? Lieutenant? Dominia's the other way. Oh, really? All right then. About face. No, no, no. You, not me. Wait, me, not you. Or other way around. Okay, let's start over. This is awful. Those machines will kill hundreds of people. Indeed, the war won't last long with the siege weapons reached Dominia. We must do something. Very well. There'll be no use carrying on sure those instruments of death serve their purpose. Let's smash them to pieces.
I guess I picked kind of a good choice there. Welcome to the command tent. I really wish it showed me what was what. As far as these upgrades go, so pretty much I can get more soldiers who are going to get killed instantly and probably not deal much damage or upgrade them. I think I'm actually just going to go for all archers because I don't see myself having enough funds to get those guys as much because it's going to be 1,000 on top of soldier pretty much. And actually, did the price go up the more I have? I thought it was 100 the first time, now it's 150. It might. But since I don't have, like, my base team doesn't have any ranged ones besides Fina, it really hurts not to have more archers. So, yeah. Okay, there is certainly a lot of them. I almost wish I kind of got a bit more death fodder, I guess you could say, but we have recruits, soldiers, two catapults, which I'm not sure if they can use them or not, and then the lieutenant. So, since, I don't know, I'm kind of tempted not to cut, but at the same time, I'm kind of tempted to cut. So, that's a tricky one, but I'm thinking I'm going to put him here and protect. Let's see, can both these guys get there? Because they're going to be the weakest, or I don't know, last time they got one shot. But I don't know, I think I might just cut and cut to when it comes to dialogue sort of thing and just skip this fight. So yeah, and I think that is it. Okay, we won the fight. It was pretty close in the process of Menos did get defeated, but you know, he's not dead. Just like in the other thing where Velvet got defeated a few times in the lab. Hooray, we destroyed all the catapults. Unfortunately, I doubt those are the only ones Magus had at his disposal. We need to try catching up with the troops on this path. Otherwise, they'll use the rest of them to take Dominia. Okay, so that was pretty hard. And these aren't command tents, they just look like command tents. Although, I think the previous battles are anything to go by. Yeah, there's going to be a command tent when we get up here. So, that's something at least. Bridge.
Lieutenant, Colonel Dalkin and his little friends are becoming quite the nuisance. They must be dealt with. We shall lure them into this cutting trap. Mwah.
I'd rather you didn't laugh like that, my lord. It makes my skin crawl.
Now then, here is the plan. You stay here with some of your men.
Yes, my lord.
Then you draw them here in some fashion or another.
Yes, my lord.
Then as soon as they reinforcements will spring up and vanquish them.
Yes, my, sir, I'm not sure if I get the whole plan.
Something bothers me about it. No, no. Don't be silly. The plan will work like a charm.
If you say so, my lord.
I love it when a plan comes together.
Huh. So I assume reinforcements are going to try and ambush us from behind. Okay, so I am going to try to stick with the whole archer theme, I guess. Just because, yeah, and the price does go up. I thought it did. But yeah, archers are simply the nicest, in my opinion. Because they hit from a range, and they hit pretty hard. So, and also the catapults did attack me. And they hit pretty hard sometimes.
Surrender. You are outnumbered and weakened. There needn't be any blood set. Menos, it's not a bad idea to say please if you want to sway people.
You're quite right, Miss Fina. Surrender or we shall slaughter you, please.
Menos!
Oh no, they're here. We're going to get murdered. Quick, call in the reinforcements. But my lord... But Lord Manus told us to wait and get attacked. Over my dead body, call in those reinforcements now! They're on the wrong side.
Our situation is less than ideal. With being
surrounded and all, we need to handle this calmly and reasonably. That lieutenant does not understand tactics. And oh my god, are those paladins? Oh, that's a problem. But, can I shoot him from here? I can. So, yeah, that's why archers are so cool.
Okay, one more shot like that, and I should be able to get him. Unfortunately, it just means that all these guys are in turn going to be killed. But I think I'm going to focus on the back once again. Or I kind of did the strategy last time. Send Menos there and charge. I always forget to charge and say wait for half of them. Like, it doesn't really matter if I charge or wait for these guys, because it does the same exact thing. Oh, wait. Wait. So, yeah. Oh, I can't get there. Darn. I can charge, because she doesn't need to heal. Her charge attack, by the way, is kind of what you'd expect, I guess. I guess I can go here and protect and try and get most of them. I wanted to put them between the archers there, but hopefully they won't attack the archers. At least one of them can't be attacked now. But, yeah, I think I'm going to do what I did last time, though, and just cut out this fight. I should have done that earlier. I was too focused on tactics. But, yeah, I would like to try and get one more victory in this episode, just so I don't draw this out too long, because we already spent a few episodes going after this one thing, and I don't know, I guess getting the Magi Key will take up the rest of the series, or most of it, like I kind of was expecting, but and I thought maybe it wouldn't at first, but yeah. Anyway, I'm going to cut till I win this battle, or lose, whatever happens. So, yeah. And I think that is victory. There we go. That was probably the best battle I had. Phew, we got out of that pickle. But they still have more catapults. I guess they must be building them somewhere around here. We better scout out the area.
Time is of the essence. I say we reach Dominia as quick as we can. Enough blathering. Kuro will lead us.
So now we have the choice between trying to find their catapult factory. Is it here? Catapults! What do you know? What is there? Or quickly heading to Dominia. So I take it... Oh, so that is the end. So pretty much... Huh. I don't know. I think I am going to just actually leave this till next time. So yeah, I think we've done enough battles for this episode. So I'm going to head back here. Does it save? Yes, it saves. And I also can upgrade my troops real quick. So let's see. Can I get another archer? Should be able to. Almost an archer, or two archers, actually. Oh, I can get an archer and a recruit. I thought I was going to be short on that. So, yeah, I got an archer and a recruit. So, yeah, I'm going to end off the episode here. So, hopefully you enjoyed. And in the next episode, hopefully we can either go after Dominia, or try and save Dominia, or go and stop the catapults. Whatever I decide, either way, we're going to end up in Dominia sooner or later. So, yeah, anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this episode. Until next time, goodbye.